Hello my YouTube friends, welcome back to the channel. In today's video I'm going to show you how to connect the Bible Show software into the OBS studio. Now if you're just coming across the channel for the first time, remember to smash that red subscribe button below, turn on the notification bell so you'll be the first to get notified whenever I upload videos like this on this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, smash that like button, just click one, so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend this video to other people on the YouTube community. And without any further ado, let's jump right in to the tutorial. And the first thing that you're going to do is to go ahead and install the Bible Show software. I've also dropped the link in the description below. Go ahead and install the Bible Show software, okay? Install it on your Windows. Now, once you're done installing the Bible Show software, also download the OBS NDI plugin. Now, just going to OBS NDI plugin. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Now, this right here is what you need to download as well. Once you've downloaded the Bible Show, also download the OBS NDI plugin. I'm also going to drop the link in the description below as well, so that you can also follow that to download it. Now this is the particular one I'm going to drop, and the OBS NDI 4.9.0 window installer is the one you are going to download. This particular one here is the one you are going to download. You see the third one, that's the one you are going to download. Now go ahead and download and install it on your PC to enable you to use the NDI on your OBS studio. And once you're done downloading and installing the OBS NDI plugin, restart your PC, okay? Restart your PC so that you can be able to see the NDI, this NDI source. When I click on this add button here, this NDI source, so that you can be able to see it on your OBS software, okay? Open the Bible Show software. Once you're done installing it, I'm just going to open my hair. Now this is the Bible Show software, and this is how it looks like. And for those of you that don't know your way navigating through the Bible Show software, or just coming across the Bible Show software for the first time, I've also done a comprehensive video guide on how you can be able to navigate your way through the Bible Show software, change the background, change your theme, do so many settings that you need to do on the Bible Show software. So I'm also going to leave the link in the description below as well, so you can go ahead and check it out, okay? Note, I'm using the OBS 27. Now I upgraded to the OBS 28 and discovered that the NDI capture is not working on the OBS 28, and they are yet to fix it, okay? So if you're using the OBS 28, you might find it difficult, you know, doing this, because the NDI on the OBS 28 is not working. The plugin is not working on the OBS 28, so you can downgrade back to the OBS 27 and you'll be able to do this, okay? Now once you already open the OBS software, go back to the Bible Show, and on the Bible Show you see that on the option tab you see themes, collection, preferences and Bibles. Now go over to configure, and then the display, you see the display one and display two. Now we're using the display one. Now under display one, you see untick this display windows and tick the NDI output. Now tick the NDI output and untick the display window, whichever one. Just make sure this NDI output is ticked and the display window is unticked as well. Once you've done this, scroll down till you see the horizontal resolution. Change this to 1920 by 1080, okay? So we want a full screen display by 1080, okay? And once you're done, click on OK and then go back to themes. Now pop any themes that you want to use, because they have their own default theme on the screen, and display any scripture that you want to use just on the screen for you. And this is how it's going to look like. Now once you've already done this, remember to tick this NDI output and untick the display windows. Pop any scripture that you want to use on the screen and go back to the OBS software. On the OBS of software, click on the sources, click on this add button here, not on the scenes, on the sources, click on this add button here, which is this plus sign you're seeing here, and you see the NDI source. Remember, once you're done installing the NDI integration for OBS, restart your PC so that you can be able to see this NDI source. And let's rename this Bible display. Once you're done, click on OK. Now from here on the sources theme, click on this drop down button here, you're going to see the Bible Show NDI. Now tick the Bible Show NDI. Now how are we able to see the Bible Show NDI? Because we enabled the NDI on the Bible Show software, which is you untick the display window and tick the NDI output. Once you're done, click on OK, and this is how it's going to look like. Now let's resize this to fit in on the screen, and this is, there you go, use the transition button, and there you have it. You see, the Bible is beautifully displayed on the screen. Now, you wouldn't want it to interrupt your main camera. And the only thing you have to do is click on this add button, this is the plus sign here, on the sources, and go over to audio input capture and bring in the audio that you're using for your main camera as well, and also create a separate scene for it. For the Bible display, create a separate scene, and there you go. So you can have the two scenes together. So one will be your main camera while the other one will be the Bible display, so that it won't interrupt your main camera as well. Now, from the scenes of the Bible display team, okay, so go over to the plus button and bring in the audio that you're using for your main camera, so that when the man of God is preaching or when he's talking and you're displayed and the Bible is displayed on the screen, you can be able to hear his own audio, and those watching online can be able to hear his own audio, especially for those of you that are streaming the service, that they can be able to hear his own audio as well in the background as he is reading the scripture, or whoever that is reading the scripture, okay. And that is, you can switch back and forth between the main scene. Once it's done reading the scripture, you pop back your main camera, and once it's time for scripture, you pop the scripture theme. Okay, now go back to the Bible Show software. If you want to use lower third, it's actually very simple. You can use lower third on OBS. Now click on this download button on the themes, this download button here, and from the themes collections, from the themes collection here, see the select package themes collection. Select that and tick the themes collection sys, which this is the theme that contains the lower third. And from here now, click on download and install, and this will install the lower third for you. And once you already installed the lower third, go over to themes, scroll down till you see the lower third that you recently installed. Now I'm just going to scroll down here, and these are the lower third, you have them on the screen here. These are the lower third here. You can just select any one that you want to use and pop any scripture you on the screen, this scripture here. Go back to the OBS and you can see how it's looking beautifully on the screen. You can see how the lower third is on the screen. So you can use this one with your main camera, so that as the man of God is preaching, the Bible will also be displayed on the lower third. That's if you want to display it on lower third, okay. So if you want to use it on lower third, there's no need of you creating a separate scene for it. You can use it. Now once it's done, just use this I sign here, this hide button here, to hide it and pop in your only your camera, and once it's time, unhide it and pop it in on the screen, okay. So you can also use it on, if you're using the full display, you can also use it on your main camera, but I just don't want things to get complicated for you. You can use this hide button here to hide it. Once it's done reading it, pop in your main camera. Once it's time for scripture, you unhide and pop it in on the screen as well for you. So whichever one is most suitable for you, you can also do that. And this is how to connect the Bible Show software into the OBS studio. If there's any part that gets you confused or you don't understand at all, you have any requests for me, write to me in the comment section below, and I will try my best to get that done, or the question answered, or the video recorded for you, a guide, so that you can also use it to learn how to carry out whichever challenges you're facing. So see you in the next video.